It's not hard to guess. They tried to shut down an experiment they didn't understand. Something went wrong and it killed them.
No. We killed them.
Now, that doesn't sound like the same man who grabbed a phaser and defended his captain 12 years ago.
I've had 12 years to think about it. And if I had it to do over again, I would have grabbed the phaser and pointed it at you instead of them.
So on reflection, you'd rather be a traitor than a hero.
I wasn't a hero, and neither were you. What you did was wrong, and I was wrong to support you, but I was too young and too stupid to realize it. You were the captain, I was the ensign. I was just following orders.
And if you hadn't, you'd be dead right now, along with all the rest of them. Dead because you listened to a bunch of mutinous cowards who were too blinded by fear to see what I was trying to do.
They were brave enough to risk their lives to stop you from violating a treaty the Federation signed in good faith.
That treaty has bound our hands and given the Romulans a tactical advantage for the last 60 years. I was simply trying to level the playing field.
And now you want to try it again? How many people will die this time? 50? 100? 1,000?
All right, you don't want to help me, fine. But you are still under my direct orders not to talk about what you know, and I expect you to follow those orders to the letter. I made you, mister, and I can break you just as easily. Do you understand me, Commander?
I got to away, team. Prepare to return to the ship immediately.
Stand by, Enterprise. Pressman to Enterprise. Two people and one piece of equipment to beam up. Report.
The Romulans have destroyed the entrance to the chasm with their disruptors. They've sealed us in.
Sir, there's an incoming message. It is from the Warbird.
On screen.
Aye, sir.
Captain, you seem to be in a very unfortunate circumstance. How can we help?
Are you responsible for this?
I'm not sure. We were conducting some geological experiments on the surface of the asteroid. It is entirely possible that we accidentally sealed you in. If only we had known you were beneath the surface, if you had shared your plans with us, this might have been avoided.
What do you want, Cyril?
I don't want anything, Captain, but I will offer to help you.
How?
By transporting your crew aboard my ship. We'll take you back to Romulus, where, after a short stay as our guests, you will be returned to the Federation.
Thank you for your generous offer. I will take it under advisement.
As you wish. We will be continuing our research in this system for a while longer. I await your decision.
We can't do it. If we abandon the Enterprise, they'll come back here and get their hands on both ships.
Agreed. Options.
Captain, I believe we could use the phasers to cut our way out.
The asteroid's internal structure is highly unstable. Any attempt to cut through the rock could cause the entire chasm to collapse.
Captain, I have a suggestion. There's a piece of equipment in Admiral Pressman's quarters under guard that might get us out of here. It's a prototype for a Federation cloaking device.
You just ended your career, Will.
That's what it's about. A cloaking device. In the Treaty of Algeron, the Federation specifically agreed not to develop cloaking technology.
And that treaty is the biggest mistake we ever made. It's kept us from exploiting a vital area of defense.
That treaty has kept us in peace for 60 years.
And as a Starfleet officer, you're supposed to uphold it.
Now that's enough! I'm taking command of this vessel. Mr. Worf, escort the captain to his quarters.
I don't think anyone's going to come to your defense this time.
How do we use the cloak to escape from the asteroid?
It's more than just a cloak. It changes the structure of matter. In theory, a ship using this device could pass through normal matter.
I see why you're so eager to find it.
And can't you see the potential here? The phase.